friends and family, Sana here. Welcome to Church Today. We're so honored and grateful for the ability and the platform that we've been given to be able to minister to you from wherever around the country or wherever around the world, actually, you may be watching from. We're so grateful and honored that over this past, 15 weeks, we've had the opportunity to reach so many people. We've had the opportunity to be able to minister the gospel of Jesus Christ to so many people. And it's only by way of God, but also by way of you having a willing heart to share these messages, to share this worship service, to share our music with people so that others can be in contact with the move of God that is happening here. So with that being said, if you have a Facebook or YouTube account, subscribe to the channel here, follow us on Facebook or on Instagram too. We have all of those things available and accessible to you so that you don't miss what's going on here. Also, we have our website. Our website is under a different URL, but it's still packaged in a very similar and very easy to use way for all of you. It's user interface friendly. So if you would like to hop onto our website, the link to the website is in the description box at the bottom of each video. Also, we have an app. So if you want to go to the App Store or Google Play, you will find us at the Wellspring Church. You'll find our app accessible on each of those platforms. So I just wanted to let you all know that, and without further ado, let's hop into worship.
Trumpets call, it's your voice, in the year of Jubilee. O te whātala whātu i le suafa manu mālo tātou li i whaolo Iesu Kristo, i le tātou e kālesia. Atasi e maainga ma wō ma whai o na tāpua i whātasi i le nei lava tāiau fōu, le aso pa ia le li. Mālo le soifua maua, ia ma le tāiau manuia. Ia manuia le alo atu o le tātou nuu, ia i le tātou tāpua inga i le nei lava tāiau. Greetings and welcome to you all as we prepare to worship the Lord this morning in the name of Jesus Christ, our victorious Savior. Let us prepare our hearts as we go before the Lord this morning in worship. Let us worship God. E fie fia o loto i lau whaoletanga, o te pese atu i le li, a wā wanga lelei o ia i a te au. But I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing the Lord's praise, for he has been good to me. Olea tātou te talo. Let us pray. Lea tua sili sili e se. Le ta mā, ma le alo, ma le anganga sā. O mātou mai whātasi i le nei tāi au. E sulaina le alofa ma le anga le leo laulava a fio lo mātou o tua. Mātou te ole atu anganga pa i ae, lo mātou whesoa soa ni sili. Se ia e ngalue ina o mātou loto mo mātou anganga. Ine ia mātou o atu ai o luma i le awa ma le mienga o te tau ai. Ia i o atu le nei tāpua inga. Ile vi inga maulunga o laulava fio le atua, ono Yesu, o mātou ole mawalau atua i nei. Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we gather in your presence this morning, although not physically, yet we gather in the Spirit and through social media to give you the glory and the honor that you deserve, O God. We invoke you, O Holy Spirit, to guide and lead us as we worship you in spirit and in truth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Ole vi inga ile tua, ole pese wasaunia. Thank you. mai o tou loto mo tātou nganga, le a tātou atu lumo le tua e ala i le tātou talosanga. Let us go before the Lord in prayer this morning. Le atua pa iae. Le atua sili sili ese lava la ufio. O leona le malosi le mana a tō malawa. Peitai o lo lofa la viai. Leo mato mau aile oli oli ma le fia fia i le neitai au fō. Mato langona aile pai mai o lo nganga pa ia e taitaina la mato sauninga lotu nei. I langona lava le li ie le nganga faafutai, le nganga vivii la ufio. O au la ufio o le tupu silisili, o le atua o atua, e tumu i le alofa ma le alofa muti muti vana. Le li ie lo mātu o tu. Faafutai, faafutai tele. O lo alofa o mātou manuia ai le neitai ao lo mātou tamā. Lau e kāle sia ma lo nuu, o āinga ma wō. Tal tonu o lo whapenā o na tū mau le angalilei ma le lofo o lo ufio. I lunga o le ne kāle sia. E ui na mātou le mawhai o na poto poto whātasi. Wa atua i neile se fulu ma le lima vai aso, e le o poto poto lau i kāle sia. Ai whaafitai le li ie, o au umana o tofaina le aso sā mua mua o le māsina o iulai. O le amato utu e whaatasi ai ta mā. Ioe o la iai nisi o suinga, ono tūlanga pe o na iai le neifa ama ioti. E whaafitai le avanoa lo mātou ta mā. E mawhaiona mātou to e poto poto whaatasi. Lau i kāle sia lau āinga. Whao ina fōi la mātou sauninga peona māsani e lungo o pengo ta whailangi. E mese fōi āinga mo wō mawhai ona muli mawina le nei tāpua inga. Tau ina iavi ia lava lau o fio. I le tau mawhainga fōi, o le neka le sia. Nu mātou tāpua inga, o mātou mafutanga i la ufi. Pāfutai ta mā, o waolo o manuia lo nuu tāpua. E amata mai lava seo pito matua, se yo lava seo pito itite o mātou whānau. Tal tonu le li ie o lo fa'asa lafa o fa'a manuianga. E le ngata i lungo i mātou i Santa Rosa nei. E a fa'a pēnā fo'i a inga. E ka le sia o lo salala watu. Nisi fo'i wa fa'a pēnā na asiasi atu le atu nu. Tal tonu le li ie o lo iai peau fa'a manuianga i lungo i mātou uma ma i lato. Le langona ai le nganga whaanga e tia, le nganga whaafitai. Iu na sosolo le nei whaamai ma ua whaaina i le to tele. E peita e ulo o tū maupea le anga le leima le lofo o la ufio, i lungo le nei nuu ma le nei ka le sia. Tal tonu le li ie o lo saonga le mū i mato uma i le lofa o laula wafio. E inisi o mātu ainga, wa fia ai le nei whaama. E whaafitai ta mā, ono tālo sanga maulia leo o tal tonu, o whapenaona manuia, o a tea fo i tua i ainga. Lea nganga vivii ma lea nganga whaafitai i lau pui puinga, mo i mātou mo mātou ai. Whaafitai le li ie, whaafitai le ola, le mālosi, ma le poto, o e fo ina mai. Whaafitai tele ta mā. Whaafitai ngā luenga lau kālesia. iui na mātou le umfai o na potopoto fa'atasi e peita'i o lo umfai na fa'aauauina pea laugaluega tāla'i le gata i le tāla'i atu i tagata o lou nu'u lau ekalesia a mese fo'i nei o mātou āiga ma uō mafai ona molimau ma tapua'i fa'atasi ma i mātou fa'afetaitele le li'ie o lo'o e tali pea i o mātou talosaga tu'uina atu i ou luma e mese le to'otele o lou nu'u o tamā ma tinā o uso matua fa'afine ma fānau fo'i o lo'o maua i le gasegase pei ona tu'uina atu i lo mātou pulitini talitonu le li'ie o lo'o taufaimanuia i latou i le agalelei o lau lavafio fa'afetai le li'ie le gata iau fa'amanuiaga i la le tino le mafaufau fa'afetai iau tamā o āiga sasa'a mai galuega ma fe'au lo'o feagai pea ma nisi ou lau ekalesie fa'afetai le li'ie ua le gata i le mātou fa'asoa totonu o āiga ia e fa'apenā fo'i le mātou sao ma le mātou faitaulaga atu i lau lavafia e mese lenei taimi ua to'otele nisi ua afāina ua leai ni galuega ona tulaga o lenei fa'ama'i fa'afetaitele le li'ie fa'afetai ua le gata ai iau fa'amanuiaga i le tino le mafaufau ia mese iau fa'amanuiaga fa'aleaga fa'afetai lau tusipa'ia e aona mātou faitau ma suʻesuʻe ma sā'ili ai i le aso ma le aso mātou te maua le poto fa'aleatua e ta'ita'ina ai seo mātou ola le li'ie e mese le galuega le agaga pa'ia o lo'o tautuoloina i mātou i le aso ma le aso o lo'o fa'apenā ona e tu'itu'i mai ma fafagu ma fa'amanatu ma fa'amālosi ai mātou le fānau ina ia mātou tumau i le fa'atuatua i laufi e tauluga pea le mātou fa'afetai le taulaga e tasi ae afe le taulaga o le togiola ua uma na esaunia e ala i lou lavaalopele toe tasi iesu keriso lo mātou ali'i ma lo mātou fa'aola i lou maliu ma lou toesoifua manumālo le ua mātou maua ai le ola e fa'avavau e ala i le salamomoni ma le fa'atuatua i lau lavafia ia tumau atu le vi'iga le fa'amanū ma le fa'anetaga i laufio nei maso'uma lava e o'o i le fa'avavau Father, as we gather before you this morning with humility, we come before you acknowledging that we are sinners in need of you, Lord Jesus, our Savior. For we have sinned before you and before others. We have fallen to the desires of our hearts, the world and its temptation that surrounds us. And we have forsaken you, Lord Jesus, your word, your Holy Spirit that abides and is here with us. Yet we have fallen and have disregarded you, Lord Jesus. And we have followed the ways of this world which are wicked and evil. So we come before you, O Lord, repenting of our sins. And we ask that you please cleanse and forgive us, O Lord, by your blood, Jesus Christ, that was poured upon the cross for the forgiveness of our sins, so that we may be renewed and restored in our faith unto you as we serve you and love you and follow you, O Lord, to the best of our abilities, O Lord. You have given us gifts and talents that we must utilize to not only preach and share your love and your word, but also to sing praises, to sing glory unto you, Lord Jesus. We pray, Lord, for your blessings upon our community, our Wellsprings Church, the families, the friends who are able to witness and worship with us this morning. We ask, O Lord, for your blessings upon each and every one of them. And we continue, O Lord, to pray for those who are struggling in our community with all kinds of ailments and illness. We know that there is power in the name of Jesus. You are Jehovah Rapha, our healer. And we call upon your name, Jesus Christ. There are many, the elders of this church, brothers and sisters, children, the many names we have lifted up in our prayer corner, along with those who have contracted the coronavirus, millions who have this deadly virus. And we pray, Lord, that there is power in your name, Jesus Christ, that you will bring healing in your name, Jesus, to strengthen them, to help them recover from their ailment and sickness, and especially from this deadly coronavirus. We pray, Lord, for the doctors and the nurses, the first responders who are doing such an awesome job as you work your healing through the knowledge that you have given them. Especially, Lord, we pray for a cure for this deadly virus because it is still affecting our country. So we pray, Lord, and have faith in you that you will bring a cure to this deadly virus. We continue to pray, Lord, for those who have lost a loved one, not only due to the coronavirus, but who have lost their life due to accidents or in any other way. We pray, Lord, for comfort upon the families who have lost a loved one. We pray, Lord, for those who are homeless and those who have lost a job during this difficult time. We pray for provision upon them. We continue to pray, Lord, for the firemen and also the police officers who have dangerous jobs to protect our communities and our people. We pray for protection and your blessing upon them. We pray, Lord, for the leaders of our country and our communities as well. Lord, we ask that the fear of God will be in their hearts so that they may be able to bring peace and unity in the midst of the division that is affecting our country. For only you, Jesus Christ, can bring peace and resolution to chaos that is happening right now. So we continue to pray for our leaders. May you continue to bless them with leadership skills. And especially, may they rely on your word, the Bible, to help them through their many decisions. Lord, we pray for our community as we begin to gather again next week. Maybe there will be some that are afraid to come because of this virus. We pray, Lord, for your spirit to guide them, to let them know that you are in control, that we must trust and have faith in you. We must also follow the guidelines that are given to us so that we may gather safely, so that we be able to worship you together in spirit and in truth. Lord, as your word goes out through the many churches and congregations through social media, may your power, O Lord, be in the word and in the worship, so that we may bring glory and honor to your name. Lord, these are some of the prayers that we offer unto you, along with the silent prayers of our hearts. May your will be done. And in Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. Ole faitawina ole tuspaia, our scripture reading for this morning. I will be reading from the Samoan version. As I read from the Samoan version, the English reading will be on the screen for you to read. Maile fenga tuai, kenese lonum ta pue lua se fulmale lua. Alau faitawina mail fo epumumua, e fangata ile se fulmale lua. Genesis chapter 22, I will be reading verse 1 to verse 12 from the Samoan version. You may follow along from the screen as we will have the English version on there. Fafufonga maia ile afionga paia alu tātou atua. Ua mawae hia mea, ona tofotofo lea o lea tua ia apra amo. Ua fape mai a te ia, apra amoe. Ona tali atu lea o ia, o au le nei. Ona fetalai mai lea o ia. Ia e ave lo ata lii, o lo ata lii e tō tasi. O le ua pele ia te oe, o isa ako lava mai e alu ile nu o moria. Ma watu ia te ia fai mataulanga mū i le mea, ile tasi maunga o te tau ina atu ai ia te oe. Ona ala tu lai leo apra amo ile tai au. Ma faa no fuala na asini. Ma ave fo ye ia ni ona tau lelea e to'o lua ma isa akolo na atali'i. Mana ta isi fa fie e fai ai le tau langa mu. Ona tu lai lea o ia ma alu ile mea ua tau ina mai ai ele atua ia te ia. Uo o ile aso tolu ona te pae lea o apra amo ma ua iloa lea mea ai mamau. Ua fai atu fo i apra amo i ona tau lelea. Tali atu ia i nei male asini, a o au male tama, ma te o ue tapuai iai. Ile ma toe foi mai ia te o lua. Wa ave foi apra amo le fafie, e faiai le taulanga mu, ma fae ai ia isa ako lona atali'i. Wa ave foi ia i ona lima le afi male polo, ona oai lea o ila ua. Ona fai atu leo isa ako ilona tamaa apra amo. Ua fape atu, lo u tamae. Ona tali mai leo o ia, lo u atali ie o au le nei. Ona fai atu leo o ia, fauta, o le afi ma le fafie. Ao i fea se tama i mamo e fai ai le taulanga mu. Ona tali mai leo apra amo, lo u atali ie. E au mai e le atua se tama i mamo e mana e fai ai le taulanga mu. No fatasi e leo i la ua. Uo atu la ua i le mea na tauina mai ai e lea tua ia te ia. Ona faya lea apra amo o le fata faitaulanga i le mea. Ma faa afu i le fafie. A ua fusi fo e lona ateli o isa ako ma faa e ia te ia i le fata i lungo o le fafie. Ona apa atu lea o apra amo lona lima i le polo. Ole a fasioti lo na atali'i. Ona valauifo lea ole a angelu ole li'i ya te ia mai le langi. Ua faapea mai. Apra amo, apra amoe. Ile ua tali atu o ia, o au le nei. Ona fetalai mai lea o ia. So ia le o'o lo lima ile tama. Awa fo'i te faise me ya te ia. Awa wa oi loa nei wa e matau ile atua. Inu e le tau fia lo atali'i, o lo atali'i e tō tasi, a ua e tuu mai ia te au. Mai le whenga inga fau, mua mua le korenito i lona mata upu e iwa, ala au whaitawina mai le fo ipu e lua se fulmal fa, e wha ngata i le lua se fulmal fitu. from the New Testament, 1 Corinthians chapter 9. I will be reading from verse 24 to verse 27 from the Psalm 1 version. You may follow along on the screen as I read from our Psalm 1 version. Totele loa ea, o e tau sinio I le ala tanu, e tau sinio uma I la tau, ae maua le taui e le totasi. I whapea ona o tau tau sinio ina ia o tau maua. O I la tau uma o e fai ngō fie e fai whata tau I mea umalava. O I la tau fuoi o la tau whapea ina ia maua le pale ngō pala ngō fie. A o I tātou ina ia maua le pale e le palalava. O au nei fuoi o whapea ona momoe e le male whale tonu. U whapea ona o tui e le pei o se tui le matangi. E o te whaatu I laloina lo u nei tino ma u fai e ma polonga. Ina ne iu ina le wha maoni o au. O au sa ta ala iatu I isi tangata. May the Lord bless us in the hearing of his word, and may all honor and glory be unto him now and forevermore. Ole vi inga I lea tua ua saunia.
Ooh.
le la unga ele suafo le tu te ma male alo male nganga pa ia. Amen. Our meditation in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. O le matua e taita inei tātou ni tau mole I le kenesim tāu pui lusu malua, alo na fai upu mua mua. Our text is taken from Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. Ua mawai ia mea, o na tofu tofu lea o le atua ia apra amu. Ua faape mai a te ia, apra amu. Ua faape mai a te ia, apra amoe, o na tali atu lea o ia, o a ule nei. Sometime later, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, here I am, he replied. We are tested every day. Olo tofo tofo ina I tātou I aso uma. Olo faya le suenga, le tātou suenga I aso uma. Olo manatu na ita ina I tātou. Test, suenga, is what we take in school whether you're in the elementary or in college, or even at work, probably getting a promotion, or to make sure that all the employees are compliant in their training. Just like I did with FedEx. Millions here in the United States have taken the COVID-19 tests, which is needed to determine how many are infected, which is now at 2.5 million in America alone. There are 124,000 that have died. About 10 million worldwide have been affected, and 500,000 that have died. We have been in shutdown in this shelter in place for most of these 15 weeks. And some are starting to open up again. And the numbers is still not slowing down that much. We had just witnessed the graduations of our college and high school graduates, although without the normal gatherings because of the COVID-19. Yet we find innovative ways to celebrate their accomplishments, including those who were promoted to first grade, middle school, and high school. Again, congratulations. You have passed those tests that you have endured and finished writing those term papers. I remember when I was entered in Canaan Fo in 2002, after 12 years of working as a courier for FedEx, I received a wise counsel by Reverend Elder Kenape Eliapo. And this is what he told me. Your first semester in Canaan Fo will be your toughest. After that, everything should get better. At first, I was questioning the Toaina's reasoning. Yet, as I struggled through the first semester, I found out he was absolutely right. I have never been so stressed out in my life as I was the first semester, especially during the time of exams and papers that were due. I knew I was overwhelmed because after 10 years of not drinking beer or alcohol, it was the first time I was seriously tempted to drink. So thankfully, I drank some nice cold ice water. I'd like to share with you three points here for our sermon today. We're tested every day. First of all, obedience to the call. Mumua, usita'i ile vala'uina. God called Abraham in verse 1, which is our text. Sometime later, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, here I am, he replied in verse 1. And then verse 2, to take your son whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you. And what did Abraham do after pondering on it throughout the night? He woke up and did exactly as he was commanded. Sausita ia e apra amo le vala au I le foi upu mumua o lo fai matato matua. Umavai e mea o na tofo tofo le le atua ia apra amo. O faape mai a te ia apra amoe. O na tali atu lea o ia o au le nei. Ma le foi pue lua o na fetalai mai lea o ia ia ave lo atali e to tasi o isa ako. Ma e alu I le nuu Moria, ma watu ia te e whaima taulanga mū I le mea I le tasi maunga o te tauina atu ai ia te oe. Tō telo tātou, e whaia ina I le vala aule nei, Pe maleiva se fulu maleiva pasene o tātou e le taliaina leva la au pei o au fo. Masalo e tātou te tau mawhai e so sola e pei o, o Iona. Ua le alu ini neva au a sola ngai i tāsesa i le va. E ui i le whainga tā o le vala au le atua i Abraham. A sa tu lai o ia i le tae o po e sauni lana malanga. Malona atalii o isa ako. Mana au au nai to o lua. Amazingly, many of us would have failed this test in the beginning of the call that was of Abraham. We would be like Jonah, who tried to run away from delivering the message of salvation to the people of Nineveh, or maybe just pretend as though God wasn't calling. I'm sure ignoring God would have been difficult for a man like Abraham, who trusted God. As much as Abraham struggled with God's command, he knew that God is always faithful. God knows best. God was never going to let Abraham kill his son. He wanted to see how far his servant Abraham would take it. This was a test, and praise the Lord, Abraham passed this most difficult task. First, Abraham had to be obedient to the call. Fausita ia Abraham le vala awa le tua. The story of Jesus walking on water in Matthew chapter 14, verse 22 to 36. It says, after a long day of preaching and the miracle of feeding 5,000 men, not including women and children. So we are talking about, I would say, about 20,000 or more people that were there that Jesus fed. Jesus was exhausted and told his disciples to go ahead of him across the lake while he remained back and prayed. As the disciples were traveling on the boat to the other side of a storm came and they were afraid. To make matters worse, they saw someone walking on the lake and thought it was a ghost. Then Jesus spoke to them in verse 27. Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid. Peter was the only brave one to ask Jesus to tell me to come to you on the water. Verse 29. When Jesus said to Peter, come, Peter didn't hesitate. He accepted the call and walked towards Jesus on the water. Peter was either brave or just wanted to be the first to try something, to get recognition. That was Peter's character. Maybe some of us can relate to Peter. Fatua umo na launga tu Yesu ile motu tangata maya fafanga ile tawa fai o tamalo lo ile mafi ile fai tawi na fafine mafana. Na tato ilo leo masalo e ova tu male lu se fulu afi ila to sa fafanga e Yesu ya reto ile ma mai e lua. Sa ia fetalai atu yona so, lātou te mua mua atu i le tasi tu o le vai. Sei nofo o ia matatalo. A o malanga ale au so o, na fetaiai lātou fetaiai, ma le matangi. Fai mai le foipo e loso, ua e loa mai e le au so o, ua loa mai le au so o ia, ua sa vali i lungo o le vai. O na lātou atu, vale ai lea. O fapeane, o le eitu, o na lato ui o lea i le matau. Famele fui poe lusufito, o na fetalai atu leo Yesu, ya te i lato, o fape atu, ia o tou loto te tele, o a u lava, aua tou te matata. O pe te u lava na mua mua fai atu ya Yesu, a fai o oe, ia e fetalai mai ya te au, o te alu atu ya te oe lungo le vai. O na fetalai leo Yesu, i nā sawia. O na talia lea pe teo le vala au. Number two, o le manatulo na lua. Our second point is discipline. You see, discipline is the practice of training people to obey rules or a code of behavior, using punishment to correct disobedience. O le usita ia lea o tu lafono, o le winga lea o le discipline. Ma tu langa masani o le ola pu lea. I totonu o nisio a inga, inga luenga e mese e milteli e malose e upu lea o le discipline. It takes discipline to wake up early and prepare for a trip that his son Isaac and two servants, especially knowing the difficult tasks at hand. It takes discipline and devotion to fulfill a calling that is impossible to almost everyone. Abraham was devoted to God. He was disciplined. Sa na no tai mo si ta ia e apraamo le tua. Sa nga tu tonu le tua i mea uma sa fa apraamo. Sa tu e apraamo lo na fa moe moe i le tua. O le mea le na ala iu na fa inga ta tele le usi ta ia o le neipolo inga o tu ina mai le tua mo ia. You see, human sacrifice was a pagan thing to do. I am sure this whole process was devastating and difficult for Abraham. Abraham thought, all right, God, I have obeyed you from the beginning when I left home to wander in the wilderness as nomads. And God has always fulfilled his blessing upon him. Abraham and his family, including the promise of Isaac, his son, in their old age, and Sarah being barren for many years. So Abraham heard the call and then acted upon it. When they got near the place God had told him, he said to his servants, wait here. He and his son started their journey to Mount Moriah. Isaac was probably in his teenage years to be able to carry the wood for the sacrifice. Isaac started to wonder, okay, we have the wood and the fire, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? He asked in verse 7. Abraham answered in verse 8, God himself will provide a lamb for the burnt offering, my son. I'm sure Isaac thought, when they were preparing the sacrifice offering, that he would be this offering. I'm sure he could have ran away or knew his father was worse. He's still at this old age. He was probably still strong to be able to hold his son down. Well, it is said that Abraham built an altar and bound his son. I believe Isaac was obedient himself and was disciplined to not resist his father, but to go along with what was planned. Matthew chapter 14, verse 22 to 36. I'd like to take verse 24 to 31. It says in verse 29, come, he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. Verse 30, but when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink, cried out, Lord, save me. Peter was obedient and was disciplined for a few seconds or so. His eyes were focused on his Lord, Jesus. But when he lost his focus, he began to sink. You see, Abraham kept his focus and discipline on God. Peter, on the other hand, although focused and disciplined in the beginning, shortly after started to look to his surroundings and he lost his focus and he wasn't disciplined. Number three, faith is what it takes to remain disciplined and focused. The word focus is defined center of attention, central point, attention, attraction. That is why Abraham is known as the father of the faithful. Because of this act of faith. The question is, why did God ask Abraham to perform a human sacrifice? Pagan nations practice human sacrifice, but God condemned this as a terrible sin in Leviticus chapter 20, verse 1 to 5. Oleang salal mele le tua peone au maya ile leviticum ta apu luas fulu, fue pumumua ole lima. Ole faitau langa lea itangata. God did not want Isaac to die, but he wanted Abraham to sacrifice Isaac where? In his heart. So it would be clear that Abraham loved God more than he loved his promised long awaited son. Ile manatu o le tamfainga le atua ina ia i loa e Abraham e sili atu le alofo Abraham ia te ia i loa lana talii lea o Isaac. You see, this reminds me of a song that Amelia, the wife of her late husband, Brother Harry Molupe, who died in a car accident early in 1995. When she asked me to sing it with her at his funeral, the song is called "That Only God Could Love You More Than I Do." I asked Amelia to sing this same song with me on my wedding day later that same year, 1995. Before that song, I would always think that no one could love my wife, well, my girlfriend at the time, more than I. What a wonderful reminder for all of us. Only God can outlove anyone. It was faith that Abraham had that led him to accept the call by God, as difficult as it was. Many would have walked away like Jonah did. Let us see what Jonah was walking away from. It wasn't a son or a daughter being sacrificed like Abraham. It was what? It was his hatred for the people of Nineveh, for their cruelty against his people, the Israelites. Not only did they murder the Israelites, they were cruel against them. They were evil. Jonah had faith in God, but it was his hatred that caused him to lose focus, and therefore, he had no discipline. Thankfully, we have a God of second chances that restored Jonah. When Peter lost his focus and concentration, he wasn't able to stay disciplined. His faith was weakened as a result of that. Why was his faith weakened? Because in verse 30, "But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sing, cried out to the Lord, 'Save me.'" Peter was distracted by looking at his surroundings instead of focusing on the Lord Jesus. You see, that is what happens to most of us as Christians. We begin the week refreshed, renewed by the word and worship unto the Lord. We are focused on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. And then, as the week goes by, we are distracted by the world and its many temptations that it lures us away from God. We start to lose focus, like what happened to Peter. Then our discipline, and then our faith. When concentration and focus is lost, other things start to fall like a domino effect. Jesus says in verse 31, "Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. 'You of little faith.'" Ah, itera Yesu oe Peteru tangata fatu tuetiti. I say, "How we masa salumaiyai? Why did you doubt?" What keeps everything intact is faith. Ol fatu tua. You see, Abraham was faithful. That is why he was able to remain focused and be disciplined during his ordeal. Imagine how much he was suffering while obeying God's call to sacrifice his son. I love it when the Apostle Paul brings the analogy of an athlete in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24 to 27. There is much going on in Corinth after the Apostle Paul brought the gospel there. So he is writing to Timothy and the leaders of the church in Corinth, trying to resolve the many issues they were facing. One of the issues before this passage in verse 19 to 23 is that Paul says in verse 19, "Though I am free and belong to no one, I have made myself a slave to everyone, to win as many as possible." What was more important to Paul is to win many souls to the kingdom of God. We have to come down to the level of the people. We have to sit up out of our seats and reach people for the gospel. For those of us who are preaching, we need to preach the word. and have a relationship with God's people. We cannot just stay, you know, being high and mighty and leaving them on, you know, all alone. They need our help. As God requires a relationship with Him, we, as servants of God, have to have a relationship with our parishioners. Paul is exhorting us to run the race to win that prize. He is saying to run the race as though your life depended on it. I remember growing up in Pavaya'i, the village of Pavaya'i, when I was young. Like anywhere in Samoa, dogs are loose. There were no leashes on the dogs. And some of them were stray dogs. When I would walk by a house that had those loose dogs, and some of them were vicious, I would start running scared. And I believe no one could beat me in a 100-meter race during that time. Maybe Usain Bolt could, but I think nobody else could. Because I was never caught or bitten by a dog. Many of my friends probably were not so lucky. Many have been bitten by dogs. Well, I'm proud I was never, because I was fast. But when you put me in a race with another person, I might lose. We are told to run the race as though to win a prize. And to do that, we must be disciplined and focused in our training. When it is time to run, we will be prepared. There is nothing better than to know I have a chance to win, or I will win. In a physical race, we train and work hard to win a prize that will not last. It is temporary, as they do in the Olympics every 4 years. But as believers, we compete to win the crown that will last forever. So to win the crown that will last, we must be focused and disciplined in our training, because our faith is in the eternal with Jesus Christ. And that's what keeps us motivated. It keeps us focused. Paul is saying in verse 27, to humble myself, I have to strike a blow to my body so that the pain I feel will keep me humble, and to reach people for the gospel and not let any arrogance or pride in me disqualify myself for preaching the word. What Paul is saying is that we must practice what we preach. It is easy to tell others how to live, but hard to take our own advice. You see, we are tested every day. I remember this building that we have completed back in 2011. Even this property that we bought in 1998. It wasn't easy. It was difficult. It took a lot of faith. There was a time when there were not many of us, especially the building of this hall. And we took our application to Cleveland, to the UCC, the building department. And we had a difficult time trying to get our loan approved to complete this project. But we were fortunate because of our determination, our focus, our discipline, and having faith that God will provide. There was someone in Cleveland, his name was Mike White, and he understood Samoans, our culture. And he was the one that helped us out, because the application we submitted did not meet the requirements. But he vouched for us, and we were able to get that loan. And thank God, after all these years, We finished paying off that loan at the beginning of this year. So God called us. He called us to buy this property. He called us to build this building. And before this COVID-19, we were in the talks of building a church. But now, with what is going on, we may have to delay that. But what made us, what helped us help us to make it through was not only we were called, but we were determined, we were focused, and we have faith. That's what helped us make it through and to accomplish great things. And it is all glory to God. It's during this time also, I remember a few years ago, some of our youth members were so on fire. And I was proud of them because they got together on early Saturday morning and, you know, sometime during the week, just to get together and just to share the word, to have Bible studies. They were on fire for God, for the Lord. They were focused. They were determined. But yet, as the years go by, as we know, things happen. We start to lose our way, just like the Peter did. But what was wonderful about Peter is that he was restored. He was the one that preached after the day of Pentecost, and 3,000 people were baptized, became Christians. So God used Peter in mighty ways after the many faults that he had. He may have lost focus, but he was restored. And we too can be restored. We have our Bible studies on the youth on Thursdays. We have our prayer meetings on Saturday mornings, even during this pandemic. So we have ways of us to try to connect and try to fulfill our calling. We have been called by God to share his love, to share his good news. The only way for us to do that is to come together, whether physically or through social media. As long as we come together, be determined, be focused, our faith is in the Lord. He will help us make it through. We will go through our ups and our downs, but more will be lifted up because of our faith in Christ. So that is my challenge to our church. I know during this time of COVID-19, many have kind of relaxed. Hopefully you're still watching our worship services. If not, well, just to remind you, we need to get back. Get back our focus on God. We are called. We are called. O aulo ma avio lilo na langi ale pale o leo lai fa vau leo lo tato sa idea. So o se lu tau namo I tato leo fa tutua lau pele. O vala wina ta we are called. We are to be determined and to be focused. And we are to have that faith that will keep us in tune with Christ. Before I end the word for us today, I would like to invite you, if you have not accepted Jesus to be your Lord and Savior, you are being called by God to accept that gift of salvation. So please, if you are ready and are willing, I would like you to invite you to repeat after me this prayer of invitation of salvation. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner in need of you, my Savior. I repent of my sins, and I ask that you please forgive me and cleanse me by your blood. I ask that you come into my life and make me a new creation, so that I may follow you for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you have said that prayer and meant it with your heart, you are a new creation. God has called you. Called you to be determined, to be focused on Him. So if you need help, we have a website. We have an app as well. So it will be on the screen. Or you can comment below on the comments. We would love to walk with you and to help you on your new walk with Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Tayatu, il tanto ikalisir will spring, atoi ma'inga, ma wom ferna, ta poi fatasi, ilinei tayao. If a manuele tua ifufuanga, malava singo leva yaso. Thank you for worshiping with us this morning, Wellsprings Church family, as well as family and friends. May God continue to bless you. We have an announcement to make, that we will not begin our worship services this coming Sunday, July 5th, Communion Sunday. We'll give it another month until August, Communion Sunday in August, when we will start up again. Just to be safe and cautious, especially there is still this virus that is still going on around us. So again, be patient as we continue on with our online worship services for the next month, the month of July. I would like to thank again last week with the worship service for the Father's Day, as led by the First Lady, the Faletu'u Omai, and also our elderly mothers, our prayer warriors, Pa'i and Aso. Thank you so much for the leading of the service and the word and the prayers. May God bless you. Thank you so much. Again, thank you to the Faletu'u for again continuing to decorate our worship place here with flowers and decorations. Thank you so much. God continue to bless you. And also, again, thank you to the worship team for their wonderful work of singing praises and honor unto God. Thank you for all the hard work that you do. I also like to thank our crew that continues to do our online services, all the hard work and dedication and devotion being put into it. Thank you again. God bless you. Let us end in prayer. Tu mau mai o mātou lunga, ma lungo lau whānau whātua tua i le lalolangi ātua. Le fi le mua oe le atua le tamā, le lofa sā ili o Yesu Kiriso, ma le mafutanga whaiwhai pēr ma la uwhio nganga pa ia, nei māso umai o il whāvau. May the grace of God the Father, the love of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us today and always. Amen.